What's up guys, we are back with the latest iPhone 14 scoop, from final design to a long-awaited iOS 16 feature, plus possible exact performance upgrade over the iPhone 13 series. There's so much to talk about. Get ready as Apple prepares the iPhone 14 series to deliver possibly the best flagship battery of all time, especially on the Pro Max model. As we know, Apple is the undisputed king of the smartphone chip game, and they have always been one of the first, if not the first, to bring a new tech for their chip, but this time, for the first time ever, Apple's latest chip won't have the latest fabrication process and it will be behind Android chips. Yes, according to the latest rumor, Apple is still sticking to a 5-nanometer process for the third year for all of its Apple A16 chips, while the competition is using 4-nanometer process. As I said, only Apple can do this. Even with 5-nanometer process, they're still miles ahead of Samsung Exynos and Qualcomm. 4-nanometer isn't a huge jump, so Apple is reportedly skipping it and doing minor enhancements to the CPU, GPU, along with the latest LPDDR5 RAM, which will make the memory performance about 30% more efficient and 1.5 times faster than the iPhone 13 series. Again, only Apple can afford to do this because they are so ahead of competition. Apple will make their proper big fabrication process jump with the next generation chips coming with a 3-nanometer process, possibly happening for the first time on the next gen M2 series chips, and then we can see the same thing on the A17 processor for the next iPhone 15 series. It will also be Apple's first chip using the ARM V9 process, so yeah, they haven't even done that, so even more amazing gains are coming. Now, speaking of amazing, as a fan of tech, we deserve the best art, and Grid Studio literally makes the best tech art in the world. They make super high quality frames of the most legendary smartphone and tech out there, including iPhones, Google Pixel, and even the original Samsung Galaxy. You can pick up console arts as well as smartwatch art as well on their website. They have currently a promotion going on, so make sure to click on my special link in the description and get your Grid Studio art today. Now back to the news, iPhone 14 Pro and 14 Pro Max could deliver the best battery life on a flagship ever. According to Ross Young, Apple is expected to use the latest generation LTPO OLED display technology from Samsung and LG for their Pro iPhones. This will allow the displays to go down to 1Hz, which is a good improvement from the 10Hz from the previous generation, making the panels more efficient than ever. Because of this, we can see some good gains on the battery life, as well as finally see always on mode, which is again something we have seen on Android for years, but now we can see this on the Pro iPhone 14 models as well. According to Mark Gurman, this is in plans for the iOS 16. iOS 16 will be unveiled at WWDC in June next month with some really big changes, so I'm super excited. Now this week, John Prosser showed the best iPhone 14 Pro look yet. This is the most accurate and the best description of what Apple is bringing. It's still the worst looking pill hole implementation, but I don't know, a lot of people have mixed opinion now. Some people are actually getting used to this new look. Personally, I'm not sure yet. Maybe I'll get used to it. Let me know what you think about this in the comments below. Pro series are indeed getting thicker, probably because of bigger battery. The camera lenses are also thicker as well, with reported 57% larger main 48 megapixel sensor. Apple is going for a decent megapixel jump along with a large sensor, which could potentially bring some huge night mode performance gains along with low light video and of course big night mode portrait performance. The 8K video recording is also coming. John Prosser also says that the telephoto lens is getting a 7-element lens system for even better performance. As always, Apple is said to bring a special color for the iPhone 14 Pro series, and this time it could be the Sierra Purple color. What you see is literally it. This is the best representation. Let me know your final thoughts on this design, as well as what you think about Apple's recent boss move, which is sticking to 5-nanometer process with the Apple A16 chips. They will still be ahead of competition considering what Samsung Exynos and Qualcomm has delivered this year. But let me know what you think in the comments below. If you guys are new here, be sure to subscribe. With that being said, I'll see you guys later. Peace out.